Yeah, no heat wall. That's down. I got this on, and this is calling. I don't hear the power vent running. I'm gonna check that control. See what we got for power in there. Might be a bad motor. Let's see if we got power going through the control. To the motor. The motor's not running. That's what the problem is. Alright, well, I need to put a new motor in that baby. Shit. Not good. Alright, I got the power off. Let's see if that does it. Alright, killed it. I got a motor in the truck, I think. Power's off now. I need to change that motor out there. Great. This should be the motor I need right here. I got an old square plate one over there and a damper. This is the motor. Alright guys, here it is, ready. I gotta change this motor. I got the power off. Not good. Long. Usually a short, but this one's nice and long. That's good. I like that. Sun Saturday morning here. Guy wanted me to come out at night, told him first thing in the morning. Good thing. I wouldn't be doing this at night. Sometimes the plates rot out on this thing. I might have to rebuild it until this thing's hot. This is the 1132 size, I believe. Hardware too. I said, this guy's got no heat, so. I'm gonna get him going here. Alright, it's nice and secure. Wouldn't hurt to put a whole new power venter in there, to be honest with you. I ain't got one in the truck, though. I don't have one with me. See how nice and long these wires are? Usually they're short. I like that they're long like that. Track in here through the flipping snow. Get back here. Should run now. Should fire up and looks like I gotta clean the boiler while I'm here too. It's been a while. I don't have to oil this right from the get-go. It's already oiled. For the bottom here. Not in the best shape, but that's it. That's as good as it's gonna get. You can see the flipping snow drift here. Probably 4 feet there. Snow. Well, let me get it running now and I'll change the nozzle and the filter, at least get them going. Fired right up. That's where the power venter was a problem. Had to get a little heat in the house. And I'll do the cleaning on it. Get some heat in the house because it's flipping cold in. Through the filter here. We'll put a new nozzle in it and we'll get them going. It'll be good. Ah. Look too dirty, but change it anyway. Here it comes. I'll come back and check it for you. You got them all leaking. Oh, the oil valve, that's good. Don't look too bad. See how clean that filter is? That's how they're supposed to look. That nozzle's gotta go. Big fan of this type of head, but it is here, so it stays. A little screw right there, you gotta tighten up, but it's clean now, good enough. Night, so I'm gonna get it back up and running for him. Hopefully these zones aren't frozen upstairs. We'll find out. Gotta get up to the low limit, which is 160 before the circulators kick in, so he's got one zone's not calling here. Unless he's got him off. Like I said, he's got a pellet stove, so it's running. Alright guys, I got zone one cover off. Thermostat jumped out because he's got it. I believe he has it off. I don't know why, but I just want to make sure both zones are coming back hot, which they are. Both returns are coming back hot, so there's no freeze up. too. And a relief valve. I gotta call the guy on that Saturday. I'll let him know about that. Well, the pressure built up a little bit, but that expansion thing's bad too. I think this diaphragm tank's gonna need to be replaced also. I need to call a guy and let him know. You see it's building up to 30 pounds and blowing the relief valve. When I got here it was 20. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change that relief in that expansion tank. I'm gonna put a rag over that control because this sucker's gonna be heavy. Bag over the burner control so if any water drops it won't ruin it. Gotta get right under it because it's gonna be flipping heavy. Well, that sucker's full of water. That's where it belongs. So I put it right in there. I gotta do the relief valve next. whenever these start leaking, I always change them if they're older. Once they start leaking, I always change them. I'm not gonna take a chance. The purge both zones out, so both returns. I got this one open already. Made of water purging out here. The water's going in, going up the supply, coming back to return, and out the hose. Both returns are off. I'll do that one next. Put my hand on it and run the shit out of it. It runs clear. And what's happening is it was heating up and the water had no place to expand because the tank was had no place to expand because there was water in the tank and blowing the relief valve. So I'd rather do it like that. We can get this out if we have to. We got room. Nice and clean now. Easily can tell by holding it. What I'll do is I'll switch it over to the side. I'd rather do the job while I'm here and get it done right. Can hear the air. It's all air coming out. Put that under safety so I wouldn't ruin that control. I got a new power venter motor, new expansion tank, relief valve, nozzle and filter. I got that issues. Should be running around 15 pounds, not 30. Like I said, I can usually tell right by holding the hose if it's running clear. We're good to go now. Now when the water heats up, it will expand inside this new tank. It'll be okay. When you take a tank off, it should never have water in it. That one's full. I'm gonna leave this stuff with the homeowner. New tank. Yeah, guy a slip and I'm on my way.